Scripture is found in Luke chapter 5, verses 12 through 16. Once, when he was in one of the cities, there was a man covered with leprosy. When he saw Jesus, he bowed with his face to the ground and begged him, "Lord, if you choose, you can make me clean." Then Jesus stretched out his hand, touched him, and said, "I do choose. Be made clean." Immediately, the leprosy left him. And he ordered him to tell no one. "Go," he said, "and show yourself to the priest, and as Moses commanded, make an offering for your cleansing, for a testimony to them." But now more than ever, the word about Jesus spread abroad. Many crowds would gather to hear him and to be cured of their diseases. But he would withdraw to deserted places and pray. Lord, I ask in your name that you would bless this reading of your Holy Scripture to us and to our following. I ask this in your name, Jesus. Amen. Help us, Jesus. Now, I automatically do a devotion every morning, pretty automatically, Jesus Call. And I used to just go through like 5 devotions, and I felt like the Lord just said to me, "Less is more." But this morning, I felt like the Lord say to me, "Hit our daily bread," which I did. Top of the microphone there. I'm sorry. Hit our daily bread, but stay away from the microphone. Word from the Lord. And our daily bread this morning was directly related to the message. Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. Our theme this morning is the red flag in racing. The red flag in racing means stop. Everybody out of the pool. Stop. You cannot do anything in racing when that red flag is up. Nothing in the pits. You shouldn't do anything. Red flags are extremely uncomfortable for race car drivers. The biggest complaint is being very hot and stopped, and there's nothing you can do. Everything stops. Everything. It's usually due to bad weather or accidents. And once they find out that everyone is okay, you know, usually what's often left is frustration and just sitting in your car and being hot. We love to go fast. Race car drivers love to go fast. They don't like to stop. God like gave me some audibles, you know, through this. And, you know, red flags can be big or they can be little. It's you're in the middle of something, but then all of a sudden you have to stop. The other day, not that long ago, I went out in my car to get something, get a couple things, and the rain, the deluge of rain that just came down. And now, look at me. How do I hold the umbrella? and I was not a happy camper. I waited. Or how about when one of those beautiful cell phones that we have, it just doesn't respond to us as fast as we would like. Or the computer. Now these are minor things, little red flags in life that cause us to stop. By the way, the leper in this story, talk about a red flag in life. He wasn't stuck in his car because of rain. And by the way, like I felt like the Lord said to me, like, pray, use this time. Use this red flag time. It's a holy pause. Or when that red light happens. A red flag. Are you going to get angry? Or maybe God's trying to slow you down. Help us, Jesus. Red flags happen in life. And although it's not officially a red flag, a pit stop is kind of like a red flag. We need pit stops too in life. When faced with red flags, we can trust God to be our strength. The last line in the developer of this study says, when we're racing, it matters what we did when we weren't racing. When we're racing, it matters what we did when we weren't racing. Sometimes what happens in us while we wait is more important than what it is we're waiting for. From a pastor who wrote a Bible study. Sometimes what happens in us while we are waiting is more important than what it is we are waiting for. So this morning's daily bread, the doctor's words landed in her heart with a thud. It was cancer. Her world stopped as she thought of her husband and children. They had prayed diligently, hoping for a different outcome. What would they do? With tears streaming down her face, she said softly, God, this is beyond our control. Please be our strength. What do we do when the prognosis is devastating? When our circumstances are beyond our control? Where do we turn when the outlook seems hopeless? The red flags in life. We all face red flags in life. This leper in this story, his life was destroyed. He couldn't live with his family. He couldn't be a part of the town, the village. His body was covered with leprosy. And he just cried out to the Lord for mercy. He said, Jesus, you gotta help me. Who can relate to that this morning? I know I can. Jesus, you've got to help me. If you can relate to that, say amen.
Amen.
One of the speakers, Juliet Funt, Alan Funt's daughter, to younger people, it's candid camera. It was, as Juliet Funt described, it was pumped with manners. And to older people, Pumped is a show that's like Candid Camera squared on steroids. One of the speakers gave a talk entitled The Strategic Pause. She offered the pause as becoming a memory. Often we can be 100% exertion and 0% thoughtfulness. We're in the age of overload. Just the information explosion. We're too busy to become less busy. However, the pause is a place of power. Is a pause, in a pause, great ideas can embrace us with their presence.
Jesus Christ made sure he had stops and pauses in his life. And one of the secrets of Jesus' success, he often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. Difficult circumstances, red flags in life, sickness, family crisis, financial trouble, and then this global leadership summit that we sat down. My, the world, I mean, we are among the most prosperous people on the planet. And there's a world out there that makes our hurts seem less and less. Help us, Jesus. God calls us, point two. God calls us to find value in the pauses. God calls us to find him, or to let us be found by him in the stops and pauses of life, the red flags of life. Now maybe, I also know people are just incredibly bored, but that can be as tyrannical as constant busyness. If you're bored, I don't know what to do, because God can break into that too. And God wants to break into that. God calls us to find value in the pauses. Marv Adona in the book, Keeping the Sabbath Holy, there was a wagon train, this was years ago, heading west on the Oregon Trail. It was starting to get cold. They had done Sabbath up to a certain point. They had an argument. Do we keep Sabbath now or do we keep going? Half the group decided to keep Sabbath. Half the group said we just got to press on. Which group do you think made it quicker to Oregon? The Sabbath keepers. Another red flag moment, the Global Leadership Summit, was by a person named Immaculate that Jim wondrously told you about. She had a red flag moment, because when she was saying the Lord's Prayer, a part of it just, God, you gotta help me with this. And the part that she asked for help with was, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. She said to God, she had lost her whole family. She said to God, God, you've got to show me how to do it. And her story is that God did. She's devoted to a life of peace, hope, and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy on us and help us, Jesus. And I'm going to try to wind this down, or to wind this up. May God's red flags be holy stops and pauses in our lives. From a little thing of being stuck in your car while there's a deluge of rain, to the doctor saying it's cancer, to the Lord saying to a church, there's a whole world out there. There's so many ideas that were shared with us. A statement that was made, slavery. There have never been more slaves on the planet as now. It's right now. Human trafficking. Crazy stuff. That's existing right now. One of the speakers said, asked us to participate in what's called Freedom Sunday. God calls us to find value in the waiting by using the time to move closer to God, to listen to God for comfort, encouragement, and new direction. Comfort, encouragement, and new direction. A daily devotion. I hope everybody here does a daily devotion. Whatever works for you. First thing in the morning, a coffee break later in the morning, at night, I hope you do a daily devotion. Our daily bread, upper room, Jesus calling. There's As my New Testament professor, Dr. Koch, would say, there's an embarrassment of riches. There's a lot of stuff to connect with. Maybe you're not real busy, but maybe there's just this yearning in your heart for meaningfulness and true life. So whether it's busyness or boredom, seek the Lord. Let God interrupt whatever you're doing. This one guy that we heard in the Global Leadership Summit, he had this beautiful business. He was an honest businessman, good guy, a pump business, and I can't do it justice the way he told this story. He had us rolling in the aisles. A guy came, you know, and said that he was going on a mission trip to put in a pump, you know, and the guy said, hey, I always wanted to go on a mission trip. And he, you know, was saying in the streets, the last thing I want to do is to go on a mission trip. And so he goes on this mission trip, and it ends up, you know, this guy, his life is planned, he's going to retire, fish, just have a good old time with he and his wife. And that one mission trip changed his life. And he ended up, a friend of his, providentially, you know, his friend, I hadn't seen his friend for 2 years, as a friend, design a pump for $20, a hand pump. And instead of just a quiet retirement, this guy is now a part of providing fresh water all over the world. Whether it's stopping at a red light you didn't want to stop at, or just like that leprosy guy, where you just stop cold in your tracks. God, you gotta help me. May the red flags be a blessing in our lives. All God's people say.
Amen.
Help us, Jesus. Again, I just will simply pray. Help the red flags, the stops, to be a blessing in each of our lives. It's in your name we pray, Jesus. And all God's people said,
Amen. Amen.